गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, डॉक्टर योगेश पतिंगे, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन कॉमर्स, जीएस कॉलेज ऑफ कॉमर्स वर्धा। फ्रॉम टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट यूनिट नंबर 4 ऑफ सर्विस सेक्टर मैनेजमेंट इन कॉम सेकेंड ईयर थर्ड सेमेस्टर। इन यूनिट नंबर 4 वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन प्लानिंग एंड मैनेजिंग सर्विस डिलीवरी। वी आर एट द एंड ऑफ अवर सिलेबस इन नेक्स्ट टू और टू और थ्री लेक्चर्स वी आर गोइंग टू फिनिश अवर सिलेबस। In unit number 4, we are studying about distribution planning and managing service delivery. Right from first unit, second unit, third unit, we studied about services, different service sectors, different quality dimensions, customer perception, customer requirements. And at the end of our syllabus, at the end of this, in unit number 4 particularly, specifically, we are studying how a service provider should deliver his services, how a service provider distribute his services, right from his planning to distribution. That we have to study from the point of view of service provider. Unit number 4 is particularly related to that. So the first point, and which is the most important point of this particular unit number 4, is actually challenges in distribution of services. In challenges, these are the 8 challenges that we have to study under the title Challenges in Distribution of Services, which is a part of unit number 4. Now, when a service provider plans his services, when he thinks that he just want to deliver the services to customers, it is very important thing from his point of view that he should have a proper plan. He should have a proper way of delivering that services. He should have that mechanism. He should have that distribution channel. He should have that network with the help of which he can deliver his product or services to a customer. That thing he should have to be chalked out properly, because he can give 100%. He can plan his services properly. He can manufacture or produce his services properly, but when there is a need of delivering that services, those services to customer, his network should be very strong, his channels should be very strong, because with the help of which that services can reach to the designated customers who he thinks that these are his customers. So these are the challenges which are actually very important from the point of view of service provider in distribution of services. The first challenge is challenge of uncertainty of demand. Because why this is a very most important challenge? Because we don't know what will be the demand in future, because no one can predict the demand. Okay, you can control your supply, but you cannot control the demand. If you are working in a very close environment business where you have just only 10 to 20 customers, 5 to 10 customers who you can contact personally and ask them what is your demand in coming months, for coming months, that can be okay thing. But if you are actually working in an open environment where you don't know how many customers are there, what are your customers thinking about your product, what will be their demand, whether those that particular service or product depends upon a product life cycle or a seasonal life seasonal demand, so that can be very problematic thing. So it will have to be sorted out properly to find out not an exact amount of demand, but you can reach to that particular numbers. This can be a number of customers who will order a product or service from you. So this is a very important challenge for a service provider, where you don't know what will be the demand. So we can say that will be a problem of uncertainty of demand. The second one is regarding to quality. Why it is included in this challenge is because quality again is not a very fixed parameter. It depends on customers, it depends on customer perception. The person who thinks this is a quality for next consumer, he think that product is not of that good quality. So quality is again changes as per the change in a perception of customer. So we can say that that is also one type of a challenge. Again, we are a quality, we are not a quality conscious people, particularly if you think about our nation. A lot of people first give preference to quantity, and after that they think that this is actually they think that okay, this is a quality, we can manage with that. So this can be a second challenge regarding to quality. The third one is a legislation. We are a very close environment country. In case of legislations are being which control the entire environment of a market, entire environment of a business. So you just as a service provider or from the point of view of customer, everyone is being regulated by the laws. So we can't say that okay, I'm not going to follow the rules and regulation. If you are in that particular business, if you are in that particular market, and if you think that you just want to deliver that product, you just have to comply, you have to obey the rules and regulation of that particular business or the rules and regulation which are framed by the government. So the third challenge is challenge of legislation, and there are a lot of changes, there are a lot of amendments. So everything gets changed when it is related to the legislation. So you should have to be on your toes when you are working in an environment like this where everyone is going to regulate you. If you are a registered company, then a company registrar, SEBI, central government, state government. So everyone is going to be there to control you, to regulate you. They have their specific rules and regulations and you have to follow. In a tax system, you have to follow the GST rules. For a personal tax, you have to follow the income tax rules. So there is always a challenge of legislation in case of the third point. The fourth one is a challenge of electronic distribution. Now look, when you think about electronic distribution, a lot of companies are coming on online platform. They have their websites, they have their applications, and with the help of which they just want to deliver their product. It is not easy for a small company or the company which don't have the infrastructure just to come on electron this platform and deliver the products. They should have that infrastructure, they should have that IT backup, they should have those people who understand the knowledge, who have the knowledge of IT, and with the help of which they can deliver the product. So the fourth one is a challenge of electronic distribution. The fifth one is a challenge of providing value addition to customers. Customers are actually, we can say that they are moody. What they think about a product today, may their thoughts will get changed, their perception will get changed, their experiences will get changed in a latter day or in a latter duration. So it is a challenge for a service provider again and again to provide a value addition to customers. So now what is the value addition? Value addition can be extended experience, it can be a service after sales, it can be free installation, it can be a free service, it can anything which motivates the customers, which provide him a product or services along with these value additions. So these are the value additions. This value addition differs product to product, company to company, customer to customer. For example, if you order a television from online platform, then in that offers, they will offer you free installation of your television. They will come to your home and they will install that wall mount, and they will attach your TV to that wall mount and do all wirings and installation. So that is a free installation from their side, because they are providing you a product, and to offer a value addition to customers, they are providing the free installation. So these things are there. When we think about different products, those companies wants to attract the consumers and customers, and with the help of these freebies, with the help of these value addition things, they want to give more to their customer, because it will again motivate the customers, he will spread the word of mouth, and that will be again a positive thing for that particular company or service provider. So but again, it is a challenge, because if you think that you want to provide a value addition to customer, it takes budget. it needs money. It is not just a free of cost, because in our example, for example, if you are selling him a television and offering him free installation, in that case you have to provide a person, you have to give him the allowances, conveyance allowances, because he is going to travel from your office to the customer's home, and there will be the expenses regarding traveling. You have to give a salary to that particular person. These are the expenses which needs a budget. So just offering a value addition or freebies to customer, it is not a simple thing. That company, that service provider has to allocate a proper amount of budget for that thing. So that is also one type of a challenge, a bigger challenge. The sixth point is a choice of distributive channel. If there is a need of delivery of that particular product, you have to depend on a particular distribution channel, courier company, or your wholesaler channels, retailers, sub dealers, dealers. This is a channel. Then you have to just provide or transport your product from your company or your service location to the wholesaler, or you have to work in collaboration with what we can say a courier company. As we see, when we order something from online platform, online websites, they have the collaborations with courier companies, and they when you order something on that particular platform, that courier company work along with that online platform company, and they provide you that particular product. So these are the challenges, and this is not a simple thing, because you have to select a proper distributive channel, proper distribution channel. You have to select the people who know that area, you have to select the people where you think that this fits perfect for that particular area. So these are the things which are very important in case of choice of distributive channel, because that is also one type of challenge where everything is depends on your distribution channel. No matter what quality you are offering, no matter what value addition you are offering to consumers, completely depends on your distribution channel. Because if that distribution channel is not distributing that product to the customer in that stipulated span, then maybe the quality of your product or service get hampers. So that thing is very important. That distribution channel should be proper, it should have complete reach to the customer, and they need to distribute that product or service in stipulated time span. So that is also one type of challenge when we discuss a challenge in distribution of services. Next one is a challenge of customization of services. Nowadays, actually, this is a very what we can say the word of when we take a feedback from consumers, they always ask that there should be customization. Okay, some products don't offer customization, but again, for example, what we can say in a construction or in interior designing, there is a means there is a chance of 100% of customization. Or even nowadays, you just want to purchase a car, the big companies like BMW, Mercedes, these companies offer you customization of the car. They can change the colors of fabrics, they can change the color of bonnet, or they just give you the different designs of what we can say the wheel, alloy wheels. So that is a customization. 5 to 10 years ago, this thing was not possible, but now this is a demand of consumers, customers, and they are ready to pay anything for this type of customization. So customization is also a challenge for these companies. Okay, big companies can do these things, but the companies which don't have that budget, which don't have that human resource, it is very hard for them to offer customization to consumers or customers, because customization means actually it has a vast scope. Everything can change. Anything just consumer wants to change, they don't like this color, they don't like that dimensions, they don't love, they want to change anything, everything. So it is not possible for a small company which have a limit of budget. So customization, again, a challenge for small companies. Big companies can do these things very easily, but for small companies it can certainly a very big challenge of customization. And the last one is challenge of employee motivation. You don't have that any what we can say a straight formula for motivating anyone. Motivation depends again person to person. If someone gets motivated by drinking a tea, another one just hates that tea. So motivation is actually depends on a person. So as an employer, it is very hard to motivate the employee just sticking to a same road or same formula. They have to apply different things, they have to apply different rules, they have to apply different attractions, use different attractions. They have to apply different motivating theories for employees and can motivate their employees. So these are all challenges. Okay, these are not all challenges which just come in a very short span. They are spread up the journey of that particular product or service delivery. But again, this is very important portion from examination point of view, challenges in distribution of services. So I hope you understand this thing. We will conclude this unit 2 in next two lectures. In next lecture, we will see another point which is related to this managing service delivery. I hope you understand this thing. Thank you.